In this week's Torah reading of Vayelach, Moshe is giving his farewell speech. He says that his disciple Joshua will take over leadership, he'll lead the Jewish nation to battle to conquer the land of Israel, and no worries, everything is set. But things change when God summons Moshe and Joshua to the Mishkan for a private audience. There, God tells Moshe that after he passes away, the Jewish people will transgress the covenant and worship the gods of the other nations in the land. But wait, why should God bring the Jewish people into the land of Israel only to defile it with idol worship? Imagine a play director practicing with his actors a Broadway show for months, and then on opening night he tells them, "I know you guys are going to blow it tonight." What do you mean? They practice more. And the same with God. Let the Jews wander another 40 years in the desert to prepare correctly for entering the land of Israel. Why bring them into the land of Israel and say, "I know you guys are going to blow it"? The Holy Satmar Rebbe says the same thing. He says the Zionists came to Israel and defiled the land by breaking the covenant and going against the Torah. It would have been better that they not come at all. This reminds me of a story from a few years after the establishment of the state of Israel. When the religious Jews of Yemen and North Africa began to make aliyah to Israel, they left their Jewish observance. The head of the Aliyah Department of the Jewish Agency at that time was a religious Jew, Rabbi Shlomo Zalman Shragai. He felt pain, guilt, that he was bringing wave after wave of Jews and they were leaving their religious observance. Seemingly better that they remain there in North Africa and remain religious Jews. So he went to consult the famous chief rabbi of Jerusalem, Rabbi Tzvi Pesach Frank. Rabbi Frank opened the Jewish source, Yalkut Shimoni, and read to him. Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Halavai Yehevun Bnei Ami Be'eret Yisrael, Af Al Pi Shemetamim Ota. So says God, I wish my people would be in the land of Israel, even though they defile it. Rabbi Frank turned to Rabbi Shragai and said, "Do you want me to tell you to go against this teaching of our rabbis? Of course you have to do everything in your power to maintain their religious observance, but it's incumbent upon you to bring them to the land. And what happens next, that's already Behadei Kafshei Rachmana. That's already in the hands of God." Years later, the same Rabbi Shragai visited France and saw those North African Jews who didn't make Aliyah to Israel. He saw that not only had they stopped observing Torah, they had intermarried and completely abandoned the fold. Then Rabbi Shragai understood that the towering perspective of Rabbi Frank was greater than just the immediate consequences. And this brings us back to this week's Torah reading. When the Jews enter the land of Israel, the path is paved with crises. We drift away from Hashem and we suffer the consequences, but then we tap newfound strength to overcome and return to our glory, but now with life experience and greater wisdom. Let's take an example. Say we have here the parents of a newborn baby. And I turn to them and say, "You know, when your child reaches adolescence, he's going to stop obeying what you say." You think they'll call me when the child is 14 and say, "Hey, how did you know?" No, because that's the way the world is made. So too, God tells Moshe and Joshua, when the Jewish people enter the land and they reach national adolescence and develop, they're going to stop obeying what I say. But it's all for the good, because with each setback, we bounce back stronger. One thing we learned today is for sure. According to our ancient and holy Jewish sources, anytime a Jew makes aliyah to the land of Israel, no matter what happens next, this brings great pleasure to the God of Israel. Or in the words of God, "If only my people would be in the land of Israel, even if they defile it." Of course, with all of our efforts together and the efforts of even the beautiful and large Satmar families, every Jew will eventually rekindle his love for our heritage and we'll all live here happily ever after. I bless everybody that we all be judged favorably on Yom Kippur, and I end with the last words of the Yom Kippur service. Next year in Jerusalem, L'shana haba b'Yerushalayim.